very much. Thank you. Thanks,
So this is why I'm Traffic, we can sing along if you want. We all face the same way.
Singing. boy, given out.
And I'm just about leaving this room on Monday when Steph Parker opened the door. And she's off from England under 21s. And also, the senior colours have been awarded to you in year 9, year 10. And so the people who have received them now really have either slipped through the net in 2 years, or are late developers. But we have still 30 certificates in which to present to you, and to present them to you, I would like to introduce the lovely Mrs. Russell! Alright, the senior half colours. In basketball there's four, so the four would like to come up, and give them a clap at the end. And it's William Main, John Over, John O'Sullivan, and Tom Witch.
Come on, Lewis.
year. The reason why we brought them all out is because you all played football during the 5 years, and they have been our most successful team at the same time. So you've actually been helped by, where is he? And his dad, Mr. Phil Horn, and perhaps you can pass on our thanks to him. I know the boys gave him a big cheer, but we didn't actually have a cup to present to them. Because again, just like last year, they lost on penalties. This time to Bay House Arms, and the previous year it was to Henry Court. Please, we're in the final for 2 years running, and got into the late latter stage in the Hampshire Cup. All the time they've been playing, so they've been a tremendous ambassadors for Crofton School. So we're delighted to have them here, and so well. Well, so we'll award that. back to Stephanie. Netball senior council colours to Lana. A piece of information that she's also going for England trials, so we've got another international. Miss Tykes still manages to get a mention because although she's not doing the squash, she's still going all around with our sailing team. And we have senior captain colours for John Pink. Tennis, tennis, bowling, trampoline, volleyball, weight training, volleyball. I said volleyball twice. But there's one other one that we forgot. It's the game, thank you. The game that Crofton has given to the world. With the Moglets and the Ramblers, of course, Crofton. It's the Crofton. And basically, we just hope we've given you enough experience and skills and knowledge. Go away and actually have fun with the game school when you leave Crofton School. And again, without getting the heck of out, 99%, 98, 97% of the time, it's actually been good fun teaching you. You are actually a really good crowd, and I know at the prom, all the staff were saying it's the best prom ever. And that epitomizes how good crowd you are. And I took all those photographs, and I know this night for myself, I'm going to put the ones that we took, ready, Charles, for this? On up on Thursday. Is it Thursday? Okay. Yeah, Thursday seems to be my day at the moment, yeah. So that you can't actually look at them, don't take them, but we'll give them to you, but don't take them in case something else comes up. You don't have to take them. So we give them to you, and that'll be up on the up on Thursday when I think you're all in to do an exam. Monday then! No, first week after half term, so you've got a bit of time to build up. Right, and if I can just finish off by sincerely saying to say, hoping for you that you'll be able to meet you. I've personally seen quite a few of you, I hope, on the last 4 weeks, especially the one on July the 23rd, which is here. On behalf of Mrs. Gordon at the back, Mrs. Russell, Mrs. Russell, Mrs. Kelly, just hope you give you all the best in the examinations. Take care. Thank you.
I've already gone. Pardon me for using the song words, but we've only rehearsed this one, so. Okay, good again.
We still love you.
I love myself more. Yeah.
Chloe,
We have three major awards in the year. Victor Durham's won, and it's now time to think about the second one. The second one's called the Head Teacher's Award. The horn is going to present it. Significant contribution to academic life in the school. So it will be somebody who takes a great joy in learning, somebody who is achieving, and somebody who is achieving at the highest possible level. Now, the difficulty, of course, as it always is in this, is trying to achieve. Michael. We have to, and we're delighted to have people who were recommended for the award, but this year didn't quite make it. And we've got, in all, about 12 people who could have won it. Now, really, in another year, any one of these 12 people could have been the winner. It's very, very close, very, very tight, very difficult to be true. We're going to have 9 people who were recommended for the award, 2 people who are highly recommended for the award, and then we can only have one winner, so we'll have one winner. Now, I'll call out the recommended people in groups of 3. They can come out to collect their certificates from Mr. Warner, and we can applaud them as they come out. So the first 3 are Paul Hook, John O'Sullivan, and Alex Mortimer.
Thank you.
Matthew wrote the song, probably sing it. Thank you very much. We could easily give this award to 200 people if you ever did, because you have all, many, many times, determined, worked hard, and you have to make this year. We have to have some weight. So we'll pick them this year. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 people. We've got about 2, 4, 8 people who are recommended. And one who's highly recommended. We haven't helped many. And I'll read out the recommended people first. Now this time we're doing it with pairs, so these pairs will come out. The first two, Martin Colgate, Dave Park.
Thank you.
the end of your very last assembly here at Crofton School. Time seems to travel very quickly, especially for us old folks. I remember you, those short 5 years ago. You were all pink and well scrubbed. But so soon, just 5 short years later, you're here now in your final assembly, and I'm thinking back to the prom as well, and looking at you now and thinking, what we've got are young, confident adults. You came as children, just look at you now. This year, your year, I think has been something of a vintage year at Crofton School. I think one of the characteristics of this year has been your sense of humour. And I think that's important. We've seen a lot of it today. You've had a lot of good fun. You've known how to enjoy yourself. That is important. You've been superb. Superbly talented at all levels. We've heard about the sports awards. Some of you have achieved the highest possible achievements in sport, both as individuals and in the teams. The drama and the music, today has said it all again. We've just had a tiny small sample of what we've had from you throughout your time here. And I'm thinking back to Unplugged, drama production that you've been involved in, thinking back to fashion shows, thinking back to all the things that you've done for charities with, thinking of others. And I think that is the other major characteristic of this year that I want to remember you and will remember you for, and that's that you've looked out for each other. You've enjoyed yourselves, but you've also had time for everybody else, and you've always been there to help each other and to carry everybody through. And that makes it a real privilege for those of us who have been here to work with you. You've all worked very hard, you've all played very hard, and we wish you all the success that not only do you deserve, but we know you're going to achieve. I believe passionately in the power of youth. That's why I do this job. I believe that you are the future, not us. We have to hand over the reins to you. You will be shortly taking over, the new generation. You are the people who will make the world what it's going to be. And I'm sure it's going to be a better place. I know that you will take your responsibilities seriously, that you will continue to look out for each other and for everybody else. At the same time, I know you will have lots of fun doing it. Nothing is impossible to people like you. Believe me, absolutely nothing is beyond your grasp. There is nothing that you can't achieve if you decide you want to achieve it. Henry Ford said there are two sorts of people. There are those who say it can't be done, and there are those who say it can be done. And Henry Ford said, both of them are probably correct. Believe in yourself. Believe that you can do anything that you decide to do. I'm sure you will make the world a better place. From what I know, having met you, having had the privilege, and it really is a privilege, of working with you here at Crofton School, I'm confident that it will be a better place. And I'm confident and happy to pass the future into your hands from ours. We're very, very, very proud of you. We're going to miss you a lot. We hope we hear from you from time to time. Before I end, I do want on your behalf to say some thank yous. Thank yous to your tutors, Caroline Bloomuth, Sarah Evans, Kathy Frost, Margaret Hyde, Sue May, Jane Roots, and latterly Trevor Naylor, and of course a big thank you. Bedlam. A very big thank you on your behalf to Paul Hillier and Amanda Knight. And also to and I suggest for all of those people and all the rest of the staff who are going to miss you, believe me, we are going to miss you. Can I suggest three real Crofton cheers? Hip hip!
I'm sorry to see you leave, but this year I actually don't want you to go.